Let's go, it's your man Mike Bones. Listen, I'm dropping bombs everywhere. Boom, 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 boom. This message is entitled, God is good and life is good. Listen, God gets a bad rap with some people. You know, people sit around and say, you know, God got me in this season of my life. You know, it's religious talk. God got me in a season of, you know, of the darkness. You know, God got me in a season of, you know, of testing and trial. You know, God got me in the season of, you know, of being on the backside of the mountain, and soon he gonna move me to the front side of the mountain. Listen, you know, God killed my family member because, you know, God needed an angel in heaven. You know, how many times we hear people speak like this? It's nothing to do with the Bible, right? It's the choices that we make. It's the way that we think and the choices that we make, which allow us and put us in certain positions. Listen, my wife and I just closed on another home in a beautiful area, 4,000 square foot house. It's beautiful, it's amazing. Movie theater, huge backyard, four bedrooms, two bathrooms. It's huge, it's amazing. Beautiful neighborhood, but guess what? We could have moved there years ago. But because of our mindset and putting other things first, we stayed in the area that we was in that was not necessarily the best area, but it was just good for our business, and I was putting money into other businesses first. Now, when those other businesses didn't hit off as fast as I needed them to, we stayed in the situation that we was in terms of the house that we owned in the area previously. But that wasn't God. That was my choices. That was my decisions. Some people get sick, right, and they say, God put this sickness on me. No, he did not. Show me in the Bible that God put sickness on people, and then I'll agree with you. But nowhere in the Bible that God put sickness on people. People get sick, and even you can see it scientifically, people get sick because of the way they think. For example, when a person murmurs and complains constantly or have unforgiveness in their heart, you can see sickness build up in their body. I just watched a documentary on a lady who had cancer, and they had an EKG, right, and they put it to her body. And you can see physically within her, and as they were telling her that she is healed, she is well, and she began to believe that she was healed and well, you see the cancer dissolving through this on the screen as she was believing the words that was being spoken into her. So her body was healing herself according to her belief. Some people are sick according to their belief. You believe everybody hates you. You believe everything is against you. You believe nothing's going to work towards you. You have bitterness in your heart. You have unforgiveness in your heart. So therefore, sickness begins to evolve within your body. Ooh, that's a bomb going off. Boom! But when you understand that you control these things, that it's not God that's putting these things on you, because God is good and life is good. Right? When you think that, when people sit around at the kitchen table and they constantly say, you know, life is hard, you know, things are hard, life is not easy, all this stuff like that, it gets into your psyche and you start to embrace that. You start to receive that, but that's not the truth. The Bible said, let God be true and every man a liar. That is not true, right? When you seek God, right? God said, if you're diligent in seeking him, he will give desires of your heart. If you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall, and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So the thing is, if things is not being added to you, excuse me, and being taken away, what are you seeking? What are you seeking first? Are you seeking a job first? Are you seeking a man first? Are you seeking a woman first? Are you seeking money first? Or are you seeking God? Because when you seek God first, he gives you the wisdom and understanding to make the right decisions and choices. Are you studying his word? Because in the word, there's no book that has not been written on a particular topic that the Bible does not discuss. And it will tell you how to live, how to make money moves, how to have a good relationship, how to raise your children, what foods to eat and not to eat to take care of your body, how to have a long life. Come on, I'm dropping bombs on your head. But if you think that God is out to get you and he's the boogeyman, right? You don't understand that Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to mankind, then you're missing out on it because you think that he's holding out on you. Oh, I don't have this house because it's not my time yet. Or my business ain't take off because God, no, I'm not ready to handle it yet. Listen, if that was the case, a lot of people want to have what they have. But they know that when I'm ready, I'm just going to go get it. Because God gave you the talent and ability to go do it. But until you elevate your mind, elevate who you are as a person, elevate your skill capacity, then you won't be able to receive those things because you think that God, from an outside source, is holding things back from you. But when you're a born-again believer, God now lives on the inside of you. And so it's nothing from the outside. It's you work in concert with him, right? By following his principles, following his laws, and now you're able to take those and apply it to your life. And in doing so, you will unlock the promises that God has set forth in his word for his people. But if you don't know his promises, if you don't know his word, how can you live by it? If you're not disciplined and all you want to do is watch TV and listen to music all day, then guess what? You're not going to crack open a book. You're not going to listen to audio teachings. You're not going to buy these things to invest in your life because it's not important to you. But as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. Your whole life is going to be based off of how you think. Because God is good and life is good. He gives you choices. We will live and die by the choices that we make. And a lot of people have said to me, you know, I just made so many bad choices in the past, Mike. I don't want to make choices. But I say to them, don't you know that even if you don't make a choice, you're making a choice by not making a choice? You're making a choice to not make a choice. So basically, you're leaving other people to make choices for you. But what you got to do is learn to make choices based off the word of God. How does God say to handle money? It's in the scriptures. I teach it on this channel. How does God say to handle my relationship? I teach it on this channel. It's coming from the Bible. How does God say that I should take care of my body, that I don't have to have diabetes, that I don't have to have cancer, that I don't have to have all these problems in my body and go to the doctor so they can give me all these thousands of pills that's going to deteriorate me and kill me faster? It's in the Word of God, and I teach it on this channel. So there's nothing in life that you cannot change, right? By changing your level of thinking through the word of God, because God is good and life is good. And I don't care what state you find your life in right now, if every single day you would take a little bit of action, not a drastic amount, a little bit of action every single day to changing how you think, to changing how you view things, to changing what you hear and changing what you watch, you would change the course of your life in a year's time. In 1 year's time, you can have the body that you want. In 1 year's time, you can have the credit that you want. In 1 year's time, you can live in a house that you want. In 1 year's time, you can drive in a car you want. In 1 year's time, your life can be drastically different if every single day you take a little bit of action. Because God is good and life is good. This is your man, Mike Bowens. I'm signing off until next time, saying be blessed.